I'm so excited to tell you about a new feature that YouTube just released to all creators that's going to help you get more traffic on your YouTube channel and also send people back to your blog. Stay right there. It's coming right up. We're going to talk about YouTube's end screens. The first video you'll want to add the end screen to is your trailer video. So navigate over to your trailer video and you'll see now there's a new icon underneath the video. This is the one that looks like an end screen. Let's go there so we can add it. Now here's the interface to add the end screen. First thing I want to tell you, if you have annotations on your video, you'll have to remove them. The end screens do not work when you have annotations. So YouTube will prompt you to remove the annotation if you have one. The next thing I want you to notice is the end screens will only appear at the last 20 seconds of your video. So notice that YouTube has already set the timer at the bottom here, you'll see. Let me move that up so you can see that timer. It's already set the timer at the point that's 20 seconds before the end of the video. You get a choice of templates. So let's just take a look at the templates. These are sort of the layouts that you can use for your end screen. So for example, wherever you see the gray, that's where you're going to add one of your YouTube videos to suggest people to go to. Where you see the circle, that's sort of like a subscribe button, but YouTube is going to place your profile in this round circle. So you could place the element of a video or a playlist over on the bottom left hand corner, then your profile on the right, or in the middle. These are just the different choices of layouts. But don't be too concerned about this, because you'll see once you actually get into the editor, you can move these elements around. Okay, so just so you'll know, here's some suggested placement for the end screen that YouTube offers. Okay, I'll choose this one, which will give me either two videos or a video and a playlist or two playlists. So now YouTube has just added those two elements to my end screen. Now I also want you to notice this little view option here, and what this does is give you the ability to turn on a grid. Notice that little slightly grayed out grid there. So we'll turn that on. And it's also saying to snap the elements to the grid. Because remember, I told you, you can still move these around. Even though we picked that template, we can still move things around. All right. So now you have to choose the video or playlist. But let me just go into all the different element choices that you have. Video or playlist, a subscribe button, a channel option where you could actually promote someone else's channel, or a link to your approved website. However, you must use the video or playlist link. You can't just link to an approved website without using a video or playlist. So this link to an approved website can only be used in combination with one where you're actually leading someone to something else on YouTube. Okay, so we've got that out of the way. So here, this is where you're going to edit. You get a chance, you get the opportunity to say, I always want to link to my most recent upload, which is what I'll do here, because remember, this is my introduction video. So I'm always going to want to show in one of these elements my most recent upload. So I'll choose that option. Now, in the other option here, I'm going to use best for viewer. In other words, YouTube will pick what's best to show the person based on their watch history and their activity on YouTube. And I trust YouTube. I know they kind of know where people do and what they like. So I'm going to use this best for viewer option here. Okay. So now if I just wanted to add another element, even though we're using the template with two, let's just say I wanted to say subscribe. Then you'll notice the little round item here. In fact, I have to move one of these down so you can see it's my profile in the circle. I kind of don't want to use that option on this particular one because for one thing, it might be a little confusing. People may not understand why is this popping up here. So it's up to you, but in this case, I'm not going to use that one. All right. So now we're going to save. Notice both of these say that they're dynamic elements because, of course, my most recent upload is always going to change and best for viewer is always going to change. Now let's clear these out and pick another selection. So we would just go to edit and just delete, edit and delete. So let's try to just, instead of using the template, we're just going to add the element. So let's go with a channel. We want to promote another channel, and I'm going to put in a channel name. So here I'm just going to add in my buddy Tim Schmore. You guys all know him. And it's video creators, and I'm just going to say shout out to Tim. See, it added that element. There's Tim's profile, but I'm also getting a warning over here that at least one element must be a video or a playlist. Okay, so let's just delete that. I just wanted to show you guys how it worked. No offense, Tim. Love you. Just delete it. Now we're going to go back to adding a video or playlist. We'll just do the best for viewer as we had earlier. Okay. Now, once you have an end screen created, you'll see that it'll be much easier for you to now duplicate that same end screen onto any of your other videos. So here's the tip that I have for you on this. Go into your analytics and pick your next highest performing video. So in other words, if you go over to analytics, you're going to scroll down and you'll see your top 10 videos on this page. So we'll pick one of these to add our end screens to, and then I'll show you an even easier way to do it. Let's go into this Pinterest video. Now we're in the end screens and annotations section for that Pinterest tutorial. So what we'll do now is import from video because YouTube will show all the videos where we already have an end card. Instead of recreating the wheel, we can just grab one. So let's grab the one that we just made from the introduction video. And see, there it is. Best for viewer. Now, since we like this end screen so much, the one where YouTube picks what's best for the viewer, why don't you just use TubeBuddy? You guys know I love TubeBuddy, and here's another reason why. I can go into my TubeBuddy icon. Notice I have a bulk copy end screens option there. And I can click on this end screen and add it to my videos. So TubeBuddy just makes this process so easy because what it'll do now is load up all my videos in here and I can pick and choose the ones I want. Thanks for joining me today. I have a lot more YouTube tutorials in a playlist that I'll link in the description, and I look forward to seeing you next week when I'll have another tutorial for you. So take care and talk to you soon.